Yeah. Mowing today. Listen to some 21 Pilots music. The song Heathens came on. Makes you wonder why most of our helpers, at least in my experience in 20 years of running supervisor positions and whatnot, why is it that most of the workers that come through this industry are, quote, heathens, right? And maybe another question is, are we all just heathens? I don't know. I don't know the answer to that. Maybe we're all just heathens. You're from Texas?
Yes.
Uh-huh. That explains a lot, doesn't it?
Everything.
Yeah, definitely explains almost everything, like you just said. All right, boys, I gotta get out of here. It's time to go to work. It is Friday. Yeah. Long list. So, yeah, let's go make the world beautiful. My world's already beautiful. So, we'll see you, boys. All right, boys, so when you lose your scriptures, not a good thing. Ah, when you find your scriptures, it's a very good thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's in the old truck. Do we know why it was in the old truck? Because we had to go rescue my oldest son this morning and his broke down. What is that, a charger? Broke down a charger. Yeah. Broke down in the middle of a busy intersection with the grandson in the car with him, of course. So we had to pull up in the old truck, jump him off real quick, and roll on about our day. But now we're behind schedule considerably. But with me and him rolling, and those two beautiful machines, yeah, we're gonna knock out today, man. I ain't sweating it, man. I'll be back. Here we are. What do you think?
I'm tired. I don't wanna go home.
I'm tired. I wanna get home, too. It's Friday. Mm-hmm. Like 1 o'clock. Yeah. We got a list. List. Grass, man. So, not sure what this video is going to be about. Not sure how much footage I'll have today. I'm going to wait and see how the day progresses. But I know one thing. That list needs to be rearranged a little bit so I don't have to work this weekend. And hopefully we can scoot some stuff to Monday. That's the goal. Probably have to do a little bit on Saturday morning, but hopefully I can push on Monday. So. Alright, boys. Finish that one. Get ready to pull away. I'll show you real quick. Yep. So, yeah. Mowing today. Listen to some 21 Pilots music. The song Heathens came on. Makes you wonder why most of our helpers, at least in my experience in 20 years of running supervisor positions and whatnot, why is it that most of the workers that come through this industry are, quote, heathens? Right? And maybe another question is, are we all just heathens? I don't know. I don't know the answer to that. Maybe we're all just heathens. Anyway, checking out. Off to the next one. Yeah, we're back. It is a hot out, boy.
Extremely hot.
Yeah. It's roasting. Roasting on us today. Get ready to knock out this yard. You've already seen this yard being cut before. But, always beautiful. Beautiful yard to cut. We'll be trimming and landscaping and everything. I don't know, as soon as this weather lets up a little bit. Be a little miserable out here, the heat trying to do that kind of work right now. But yeah, the sky's ready to go. Ready to rock it out, boys. And yeah, I don't know. Probably just stay the same stripe pattern today. I'm tired. It's Friday, it's been a long week. But hey, we've been able to skip two of them already today, so that's two less we had to mess with. Two less off the two less to make money off of, but at this point in the week, I'm not really worried about that. We've made plenty this week to be okay. So we're gonna get off here and mow some grass, right? I think we're mowing grass. We could be sleeping. Nah, we're gonna knock it out. He always jumps up and works. No worries. Man. She's being brutal today, boys. Brutal. Hey, man, what can you do? Just battle on through it all, right? Let's do it.
Throw your doors off.
Rolling.
Too much fun.
Dude, that mower flies, dude.
It's ridiculous.
Oh, man. 18 mile an hour. Wine in the neighborhood. Yeah, I know you're still listening. I know you're listening. Love is up. Yeah, here we are. Last one of the day. Able to rearrange the day, so we're not going to be working too late on this Friday, which is a good thing. We were taught all week. Boom. There's man. The man laying out some stripes these days with me. Yeah, here we are. Getting ready to knock it out, so we'll be back. All right, boys. Mission accomplished for today, Friday. Not a bad day at all. Show you a little scenery real quick. New house up. All right, guys. I mentioned the song Heathens and the derogatory term heathens earlier. So we get home, I've been thinking about it today. You know, appearances, they matter. You know, they unfortunately appearances do matter, guys. I can't help that. That's the society we live in. So, you know, I may look like a heathen to some, but I don't know. We'll talk about it. All right? Peace. Going to get coffee. Appearances. How much do appearances affect your income? How much do appearances affect your clientele base? How much do your appearances affect the neighborhoods that you're even acceptable to be in working? Some questions, you know, valuable, important questions. There's so many questions, guys. You know, if I have too nice of equipment and I'm blinging too much, will I get any business? Will everybody just assume I'm overpriced no matter what I tell them just because of my appearance? If I show up in an old beater truck with dirty clothes and I haven't showered, you can tell I haven't showered, I haven't even brushed my hair for you, do you think that person's work is going to be quality? Is it going to be up to standards? If they don't have their hygiene up to standards, is their work going to be up to standards? Probably not. Whether or not that's true, hey, I've seen all sorts of people do all sorts of wonderful things in life. All right, appearances, they matter in situations, but they don't make you who you are. Customers don't know this about you yet. It's important. Honestly, guys, you guys see me dress all sorts of different ways, don't you? I mean, I'm out here in anything from no shirt to a Jimi Hendrix shirt to an A shirt. You know, some people would say this kind of gangster. I don't know. I don't have the answers. It's a lie. I got lots of answers. Doesn't mean they're right for you. I do what works for me. All right. When it comes to appearances, I don't know. I do what works for me in my business at the times that I need to be dressed nice, I'll dress nice. When I can dress down, I'll dress down. When I can go with no shirt on to catch up on my tan, I do that too, okay? So, yeah, we'll talk some more. I gotta run to the bank, so I'll take you with me. We'll chat about it, yeah.
Who's that?
What?
What are you doing?
I'm not trying to
get it. I was looking at your plants. I was showing them your plants.
I'm looking at my plants.
Are you getting too close to me for a minute? You trying to fight? Or you think so?
Relax.
Oh, just relax on your sofa. Rarely. The grandson's gone. Grandson's gone for a little while. Couple days. Go hang out with his mama. Yep, it's after work, boys. Is it time for me to sit down?
No.
Time for me to fix the pillow. Pick up the water bottle. And look at her for a second. All right, girl. Love you too. You and your Texas shirt. Dig in.
Love you.
Love you too. I'll be right back. Look how beautiful that is. That's just gorgeous. Do appearances really matter? I think they do. In many, many situations, appearances definitely matter. All right. Now, definitely I have mixed emotions on that, you know? I've worked at many companies, many different caliber of companies, levels, you know, to the one-man operation where I was the helper, to the, you know, three-man crews, to where I was just the crew supervisor, up to where I was running, you know, 15-man crews with two trucks running around and hitting like 26 complexes in a week. So I progressed all the way up through all that, and I've gone through a lot of employees for these companies, probably about 500 altogether, that I've trained over the course of my career. So heathens, right? You know, are we all heathens? Do our clients look at us like heathens? Does society look at us like heathens? Are we the lower class? You know, some people, that bothers them, that, you know, they get the feeling that people look down on them. I don't get that feeling. I've never really cared whether people thought about me and the way I looked. I just don't care. That being said, some of these companies, They have a t-shirt, company logo. Nothing wrong with that. Nice and comfortable. No worker minds wearing a t-shirt. Okay? It's just the way it is. T-shirts are fine. I did that to begin with my business. The first 2 years I was in, working all this stuff out here, I had t-shirts with my company logo on it. Then the big companies, you know. The big companies want you to wear polo shirts. Collared polo shirts. And, That was some hot mowing. Especially when they picked the dark forest green. Because it looks good. Alright. Dark forest green did look good. I'll give you that. I'll give you that, boss. Wow. You'd be out there in the humidity and the heat trying to wear some forest green polo shirts. Anyways. Sleeves got cut off by those too. Whatever, man. I bought them, paid the company for them, cut the sleeves right off. Whoosh. Hey, I had to do something to stay cool, and I still look good, all right? Now, guys, obviously, you see me wearing all sorts of stuff, right? Your company is your company. You know what your clients want you to be wearing. You know what they don't want you to be wearing. Okay, you know what's acceptable in this neighborhood that you're in now. And then the next place that you're at 2 days from now could be totally different. It's your call. I'm not here to tell you what to do and how to dress, all right? Main thing is, in my opinion, if you're clean cut and you took a shower and you brushed your hair and you brushed your teeth and you don't smell bad, that's the appearance people look at. Now, if I've done all those steps and I'm clean, but I have dirty jeans on that I've worn for 4 days out here in the field because I was too lazy to wash them, and I have a shirt that I've had for 3 years working for the company and it's stained up and gross, yeah, it kind of defeats the purpose of cleaning up and being presentable, okay? So, the last company that I was supervisor at, and the last meeting I called, was basically that. We were a cool, hippie, you know, landscaping company. Our uniforms were tie-dye. I loved it, man. It was pretty neat. Different vibes, all right? Different vibes of that company because of the hippie attitude that the owner had. At the same time, the guys would not be showered. They would not be groomed, whether it was their hair, their beards, or whatever. So, you know, I called a company meeting and I just made this point, you know. You need to be clean, you know. Take time to do a clean uniform if you have uniforms at your work. Clean yourself up. It goes a long ways. And yes, I have facial hair, and I let it grow. I trim it every once in a while. My hair been gone for a long time, okay? Easy to clean this stuff up. 3 boys at a young age, pulling your hair out, it's gone, right? So look, you don't have to get caught up in appearances to a point, okay? To a point. Another thing, your trucks. Your equipment. Does that matter? The appearance of your truck and the appearance of your equipment. Should it be clean? I don't know. Should it? Should it be clean? Should your mowers be clean? Should your truck be clean? Or just presentable? You know? we're all busy out here. Do we all have time to make everything nice and shiny? And yeah, I've never washed that skag. I've never washed either one of those skags. I think my soulmate washed my Freedom Z one time. Oh, we lost the light, boys. So, should the stuff stay clean? Meh. I don't know. You tell me. You guys tell me. Should your stuff stay clean? My stuff stays clean enough to function properly. It keeps grease in the greasing parts that need greasing. And if I wash it on Monday morning, depending on the conditions of the yards I'm cutting, it could be filthy in 1 hour. Could be filthy in 2 days. The thing's gonna be filthy again. All right. So do you put this? Do you waste time? You know, do you take the time that you could be doing other stuff? Clean these mowers. Clean your truck. Meh. Whatever. You tell me what you do. You know. Let me run over here, and I'll come back, and we'll talk about something that I think's important. It was for me. Maybe not for you. We'll find out. I love nicely logoed trucks. Don't get me wrong. Love them. I had one. When I was 24, my tree business had a beautiful, beautiful brand new GMC truck. I paid money to get it all stenciled up. It was beautiful, man. Just amazing. I loved it. I had a big bucket truck. Had the whole side of it, everything, just logoed up, man. Paid probably like $1,100, $1,200 for everything. Even put some logos on the back of my Suburban, all right? So, I'm not against logoing your trucks up. I think that looks sharp. Now, if you have employees, some of you guys have multiple employees, okay? And you have the logo and the phone number outside your truck, just expect phone calls, okay? Bottom line, expect phone calls. You will get phone calls on those trucks, on those people driving them often. Most of the time, it doesn't matter. Most time, you should have your boys' backs, all right? 98% of the time, you have your boys' backs. You have your crew's backs, all right? Deal with it how you need to deal with it, but you always have your crew's backs. They got your back, you have their back. Now look, me being solo, first couple years, yeah, I advertised, I passed out flyers, you know, that's my gig, dude. I get a stack of flyers, stack, and I go hit them up Sunday mornings before everybody gets up to go to church and check some morning paper and all that good stuff. You know, majority of Americans get up, go to church on Sundays. And I would be out there bright and early, bright and dark. All right. It was always dark. I would start at 4 a.m. with a mission of 1,000 flyers. All right. I'd hit up the neighborhoods that I wanted to hit up. I would place them strategically, legally, where people would see them and they would look at them at least. It works, all right? It's always worked. I've done it multiple times in my life. It's always worked. Cheap. Anyways, back to the trucks. Now, I chose not to have my logo on my truck. Why? Why don't you want your logo on your truck? I don't want the headache of people bugging me. I don't want everybody who passes me on the street to call my number and bug me about every little job they have. That's not the clientele I'm looking for. Alright? Never has been. I didn't want the tiny yards downtown that the nice lady, very nice lady, would want you to come pull weeds and pay you $25. Or the one man would want you to come bury one downspout, but only want to pay you $120, even though you dug, and you dug, and you dug, with a pickaxe and a shovel for 5 hours. All right. I don't want those clients. I didn't want those clients. That's the reason I don't have my logo on my vehicles. I wanted to pick and choose who my clientele was. And by me having older vehicles, you know, I didn't look big and blingy and expensive. But after they talked to me and they heard my knowledge on my landscaping knowledge, my mowing knowledge, whatever, you know, after you talk to me, you kind of realize, hey, this guy's not cheap. He told me straight up he's not cheap. But he also promised me he's going to do an excellent job and he won't be satisfied until I'm satisfied as a customer. Those are the clients I want. Those are clients I have accomplished to get. I've got them. Most of my clients, not all of them, but most of them don't ask me for quotes for jobs they want done now. They just show me the property. They show me what they want done. They already know my rates. And, you know, I'll let them know, hey, it's going to take us a day, day and a half. Here's a rate. Could be less, could be more. And we do the work. So, you know, logos on the side of your trucks. I don't know, guys. I don't know. Not for me. Not for my business. Maybe for you and your business, that's the way to go. If you're going for volume and you're trying to pack up employees on your list and just volume, 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 then yeah, logo it up. All right. Get your number nice and big. You know, put cheapest rates in town on the side of your truck. You get lots of phone calls. I promise. Hey, to each their own, guys. Everybody has to get started their own way. These are just questions of mine that I have, you know, that I've had in the past. I know the answers for my business and my company and me personally. But these are questions that I've ran across in life and wondered about. And, you know, does your company make more money if all your guys are matching in your polo shirts, as opposed to the company that has some basketball, you know, shirts, sleeveless shirts with their company logo that's more comfortable for the guys out there? Do they make less money? Do your clients, think about it. Your clients hire you to do the hard work outside. Let's think about that for a second. They know it's hot. All right, they know it's hot out here. They don't want to be out here. So a lot of your clients, they expect your workers to be somewhat comfortable to be working outside. Just me and my opinion, I get really hot. I can't wear many clothes. I get really hot. Like, my body temperature skies to the roof. You ain't gonna find me wearing long pants, jeans, boots. I'm not trudging around. I ain't walking miles. I'm not walking miles with a weed eater and a blower and pulling weeds. And I'm not doing that in boots, all right, boys? I'll do landscaping in boots. I ain't mowing in boots. All right, so, you know, do these people care what you're wearing? Do they? Do they care what you're wearing out here? To a point. Everything's to a point, guys. You know, to a point, no, they don't care. They expect you to be comfortable. All right, they expect the hard worker in their yard to be comfortable while he's working in their yard. Okay? They don't want you to have a heat stroke. But you can't look trashy. You just can't look trashy. You can't have dirty, gross clothes, ripped up jeans that you should have replaced 5 years ago because of the holes and because of the stains. I mean, if you're wearing work boots and they got, you know, Donald Duck on the front of them just quacking away because you didn't replace your boots. because you did something stupid with your money, that's unacceptable, man. Unacceptable. So, I don't know, boys. Random thoughts. Random thoughts from Randall. Be a segment now. Randall's random thoughts. This air just is kicking. Kicking. I'm freezing. Long sleeves. Coffee. I was crying the blues earlier today. Earlier in the video, I was crying the blues because the sun was beating down, killing me. Ah, dude, nature. And technology, boy.